Students, today we are going to study in this lecture about packaging of DNA in eukaryotes. In the previous lecture, we have already seen how DNA is packaged into a smaller bacterial cell, that is prokaryotic cell. Now, what is the difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic? In prokaryotic cell, the nucleus is not well organized. Why? In case of eukaryotes, as the term itself explains, eu means true or advanced, karyotes means the nucleus. So advanced nucleus. Now what are the features of advanced nucleus? It has got a nuclear membrane, nucleolus, nucleoplasm and chromatin material. Chromatin material is in the form of network of thread-like structure. Now, as we all know that the cell undergoes cell division like mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis takes place at the time of growth and development as well as wear and tear of the body, while meiosis is required at the time of gamete formation. So, at both these stages of cell division, the chromatin material undergo condensation and it forms chromosome. So, in today's lecture, we are going to see how the chromatin material gets condensed to form a thick chromosome called as a thick chromosome at the stage of metaphase. Now, the DNA molecule is a double-stranded structure made up of two strands where one strand is going in ascending direction while the other strand is moving in descending direction. Both these strands are coiled around each other to form a double helix. Okay, so DNA molecule basically made up of chemical compounds called as nucleotides. Nucleotides are in turn made up of three units, sugar, deoxyribose sugar, second phosphoric acid, which is a very strong acid, and third, it is made up of nitrogen bases, adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine. Out of these four, any one nitrogen base will make up one nucleotide. Phosphoric acid is a strong acid and that makes DNA molecule negatively charged. So, DNA packaging requires a protein which is positively charged. So, it is attracted towards protein. And for packaging of DNA, the protein used is histone and non-histone protein. Now, histone protein is rich in amino acid called as lysine and arginine. Lysine and arginine both are positively charged. Hence, histone protein is positively charged. These proteins, histone proteins, are of four types. Okay, so those four types of proteins are H1, H2, H3 and H4. H2 protein is again of two different subtypes, H2A and H2B. So total we can say there are five histone proteins. H indicates histone, H1, H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. Now for packaging of DNA, these histone molecules gather together and they form a histone core. So each histone core is also called as octamer. Why the term octamer is given? Because there are 8 molecules of histone protein which gather together to form a nucleosome or histone core. What are those 8 molecules? So, 2 of H2A, 2 molecules of H2B, 2 molecules of H3 and 2 molecules of H4. So, here in this diagram, it is a histone core or its octamer where you can see H2A, H2A, H2B, H2B twice, H3, H3 and H4, H4. So two molecules of these makes an octamer. This is called as histone core. Now to this histone core, which is rich in arginine and lysine amino acid, that is why it is positively charged, because arginine and lysine both are positively charged. So a negatively charged DNA molecule, here you can see this is a DNA molecule which is entering a histone core. It is entering a histone core, wrapping it twice. Now this two times right wrapping is, first wrapping is complete. It is a complete turn, while the second turn is 3/4. It is not completed fully. So we can say it is 1/3 turn. Okay, that turn is completed around the histone core and then it leaves the histone core. Now wherever this, at the point where the DNA molecule is entering the histone core, there is one H1 histone, and the DNA molecule where it is leaving the histone core, there is one H1 histone. So a single nucleosome is made up of two H1 at the entry point and at the exit point. So we can say that there are 10 molecules of histone in one nucleosome. So this is the diagram of nucleosome observed under electron microscope. Now if you observe it, the entire, all the nucleosome molecules, so this is a histone core where DNA, double-stranded DNA is entering the histone core, wrapping the histone core twice and leaving it. Again it will enter into another histone core, wrap it twice, that first turn is complete, second turn is 3/4, and then it is again leaving the octamer or histone core. So what you observe under electron microscope as beads on string like structure. Suppose I give you a bead, many beads and a long thread, okay, and I tell you to wrap that thread around the beads two times, circle the bead around two times and then tie it up. So what you will get is beads with tying the thread, beads with tying up the thread. In this way, the DNA or the thread which I have given you will be shortened. Okay, that structure of DNA is called as coiled structure. So it looks like beads on string like structure, and that one bead and DNA makes up a single nucleosome. So, an electron microscope shows that each nucleosome is made up of an octamer, that is histone core. In the histone core, DNA wraps the histone core twice and leaves the histone core. At the entry point, there will be one H1 histone, and at the exit point, there is one H1 histone. Now, what is the length of DNA in this histone core? The point from where the DNA enters the histone core, complete first turn and incomplete second turn, that is 1/3 turn, the length of that DNA is 146 base pair. Now what is BP, base pair? Because we all know that DNA is a double-stranded structure. It is made up of two strands, and both the strands are made up of nucleotides. And DNA double-stranded structure shows pairing in between the nucleotides. So adenine of one strand pairs with thymine of other strand by double hydrogen bond. Similarly, cytosine of one strand and guanine of another strand pair by triple hydrogen bonds. So that is base pairing, pairing of nitrogen bases. So BP is base pairing. So 146 base pairs are found in this DNA which is wrapping the histone core, and that DNA is called as core DNA. Okay, it is, as it is in the histone core, therefore the term core DNA is given. While the DNA which is joining the two histone, this is called as linker DNA. The DNA which leaves the histone core, after a short gap it enters into another histone core. Again it leaves the histone core, after a gap it joins with second histone core. So what you get is bead string. So that string is nothing but a DNA which is called as linker DNA. and length of linker DNA is 54 base pair. So one nucleosome is made up of a histone core and linker DNA. So this is histone core and linker DNA. So length of DNA in one nucleosome will be around 200 base pair. 146 plus 54, that will make 200 base pair. So length of DNA in one nucleosome is 200 base pair. Now this is first coiling of DNA. Now still we have to see how further DNA gets coiled and get accommodated as a chromosome. Okay, so now these beads on string like structure undergo further coiling. That further coiling is called as supercoiling. So this supercoiling is like a spring or like a telephone wire. You must have seen at home, to accommodate that long wire, that wire is coiled like a spring. And it is accommodating, or it is taking very small space. So in the same manner, beads on string like structure, that is histone core linker DNA, histone core linker DNA, that is beads on string like structure, coils like a telephone wire, coils like a spring. And one coil consists of 6 nucleosomes. One coil consists of 6 nucleosomes. So in this way, 6 will make up one turn, another 6 will make second turn, another 6 nucleosome will make third turn, and that forms a super coil. That super coil is called as solenoid. It is called as solenoid. Now this solenoid is around 300 angstrom thick. Now imagine that coiled wire of telephone is again subcoiled. It is called a super coiling, and due to that super coiling it forms super solenoid. Super solenoid is the thick chromosome seen at the stage of cell division, called as prophase. And further, again more condensation and coiling occurs. That is, the thickest chromosome is observed at the stage called as metaphase. So metaphasic chromosomes are thickest and can be seen with a centromere and 2 chromatids. These 2 chromatids are joined in the center by centromere. So each chromatid is in the thickest stage at the metaphase of mitosis. Okay, so in this manner, DNA packaging takes place with the help of histone. Now, what is the function of non-histone protein? Now, as we have seen already, the DNA is coiled like a spring, like a telephone wire. Then again, that telephone wire is super coiled. So, not to separate that coiling and super coiling, the DNA is held together by non-histone protein. Okay, so there is requirement of non-histone chromosomal protein. This non-histone chromosomal protein binds that coiling part, super coiled part, and keep all those loops together, held together to form the metaphase stage. So there is requirement of histone as well as non-histone protein for packaging the DNA. So we have seen in this lecture how DNA is packaged in eukaryotes. Thank you, girls.